Hey guys, Ivan here. So, New York Pro just happened. Hopefully you watched it and you enjoyed it as much as I did, because it was really good. It was exciting. A lot of guys brought really good level of conditioning, and this is your top two, a clear top two. This was the final call out in the end. The judges called out Nick Walker and Justin Rodriguez to compare them for the first spot. We're gonna go pose for pose, analyze their physiques, and see who is actually winning this show, and I think the winner is pretty clear right here. So, front double bicep. Nick is absolutely destroying this one. I mean, the details in the legs, just that. I mean, that's just enough. I mean, look at the mid part of the quads compared to Justin. Like, night and day difference. The sweep, everything. I mean, just the legs are just much, much better. The midsection too. I mean, Nick was really polished. He was really polished. That's the word. That's the word that describes his physique on this show. Polished. I mean, the stomach was just aesthetic, it was good. I mean, the waist is a bit blocky, sure, but the abs are symmetrical, they are defined, he's dry. Compared to Justin's midsection, much, much better on Nick. Bicep peaks, overall size of the arms, chest, lats, everything. Just Nick is absolutely destroying this one. So one for Nick, zero for Justin. Let's see the second pose, lat spread. Wow, wow, this one looks really good on Nick. He wasn't exactly this great at doing this shot before, but now it just looks amazing. Look at the arms and look at the conditioning of his stomach and of his legs. Just compare the legs to Justin and compare the chest and arms and shoulders and everything. Nick absolutely annihilated this pose. And while I'm talking about this, guys, I'm sweating. There's sweat dripping on me, basically, because I'm so excited about this. This was a great show. Finally, a good show. And now we have side chest, and usually this is a good pose for Justin Rodriguez. So I thought this one is gonna be won by him, but I'm not so sure, really. I mean, yeah, the chest does look thicker, and the glutes also are showing more separation, but then again, the hamstrings on Nick, and also the conditioning on the glutes as well. I'm not sure, I would give this one to Justin, but it's a very close call. So let's say two for Nick, one for Justin, but it's a close one. Now we turn to the backside. And Justin is known for having a great back and also very tight glutes usually. So we'll see what's happening here. Back double bicep. What do you think? It's very close, right? And Nick's hamstrings are something, man. He is known for those hamstrings. But Justin does have a little bit thicker back. I would have to say it's deeper. It has more thickness, more depth, right? And the glutes are also looking a little bit thicker, but Nick has tighter glutes, more conditioned. So it's very close, very, very close. I'm not sure who to give this one. Let's say this one was a draw. And now back lat spread. This was the best pose for Justin, but something happened at this show. I don't know what the hell was it. It could be something like some kind of electrolyte disbalance, because Justin just couldn't spread the lats. Something was wrong with his head. I don't know why. He just didn't do it. This is it. This is it. This is the front. This is the back lat spread. That's the way he was doing a pose. I don't know why. Maybe he has an injury so he can spread the lats. Doesn't really make a lot of sense, but maybe he thought this looks better, or maybe something was wrong with his head and he just didn't know how to do it, which is weird. Whatever is the reason, it's just wrong. It doesn't look good. For this, Nick wins this shot, even though it should be Nick. It should be Justin who wins it, because at Indie Pro, his lat spread, that was a good lat spread. That would beat Nick, but not this one. And also the conditioning of Nick in the lower body also is something. I mean, the judges are definitely seeing that from that front row. They're probably amazed at his conditioning, because he is sharp. He is sharp. So polished. Side tricep, it shows a lot of thickness on Justin, but the way Nick is doing it is very Dorian-esque. With that one leg behind, it just looks good, right? It looks very powerful. But his chest, his upper chest especially, is a little bit weaker, and it shows here. So it's close, this one as well. So I'm not sure about this one. I guess let's call it a draw once again. So right now I'm not sure what exactly is the score, but I know Nick is in the lead. And now we're gonna go to abs and thighs. None of these guys is great, because they both have blocky waists a little bit. Justin maybe has a little bit smaller waist, but his abs don't look very good. And Nick is absolutely polished, and the details in the quads, wow. Wow, so he wins this one as well, and I'm pretty sure that Nick won this show. That's it. That I'm gonna say. I'm gonna call it right now. He won the show. Most muscular. Look at this one. I mean, Justin is known for this one, but Nick, the amount of details of his entire body, this is just insane. This is crazy. I cannot say I can see him winning the Mr. Olympia, but to be one of the top pros for sure. He doesn't have really the best structure, but He does have that gnarly, grainy look. He does have a lot of details, a lot of density. I mean, you can just imagine how he trains and you see this physique. I mean, this is because he lifts so heavy and also the genetics, of course, but so much detail for sure. I mean, this is just amazing physique. The best package of him by far and one of the most impressive physiques that I saw for a while now. This is really good. He brought a good level of conditioning, crazy level of conditioning, and he is huge. He looks amazing. And in my opinion, he is a clear winner of this show. And Justin, of course, is a clear runner-up, which is also good. He qualified for the Mr. Olympia. No way he's going to win this show. No way. Nick Walker won the show. Whew, am I getting overly excited about this? Anyways, let's go with the second call-out. So third spot is going to be Hassan, because previously he was in a call-out with those two guys, along with Dorian Haywood, who is on his right. But I'm not sure about that third spot. Hassan, I'm pretty sure, based on this call-out, he is winning this call-out, so he's going to be third, no doubt about that. As far as the fourth spot, it's going to be between Blessing, Dorian Haywood, and Muhammad, right here, Muhammad Al-Mam, on the left. So, I mean, Dorian, he brought a really good level of density, like, he has so much fullness in the chest, in the back, in the glutes, in the shoulders, but he doesn't have the prettiest structure. Blessing does have a good structure, but he was not conditioned, he was off, way off, definitely much worse shape than Indie Pro. Hassan, as I thought, not super conditioned, but with his structure, with his muscular development, he will be the third spot for sure. He is fine, like, he's conditioned enough to be third, yeah, not to win the show, not nowhere near close to those top two guys. Muhammad Al-Mam, good conditioning, not the best structure, so I think Blessing is gonna be fifth here, or fourth even. So Hassan, I'm pretty sure he's third, and the fourth spot is a battle between Dorian Haywood and Blessing, and Muhammad is gonna take that sixth spot. So Blessing apparently did crack the top six, and I don't think he's gonna be sixth. I'm thinking fourth or fifth, actually, but it might go either way. Look at the Dorian here, look at his chest density and shoulders, wow. And this was the final call-out in which one Morgan Aced is gonna prevail for sure, he's gonna be seventh spot. So let me show you what Blessing actually brought, because there was a lot of talk about him winning the New York Pro, and of course he's not gonna win it. I mean, he does have the structure, no doubt about that. He does have a pretty structure, not the best arms. I don't like his arms, really. Yes, in the front double bicep for sure, but when he puts them aside, I don't really like them. But he was not conditioned this show. No, he was in way better conditioning in the Pro. He messed that up this time around. He looked a little bit watery. Not horrible, no, but like to be in the top three or something like that, nah, not even close. Hassan, yeah, just like I thought, not good conditioning, fine conditioning, fine enough to be third. If he brought good level of conditioning, he could have won the show because he has so much muscle. And this is the trick that Wax Filler showed him when he does the side tricep, and he does look good in that one. Back double bicep and back lat spread. Look at the back lat spread. Even though he's even though he's narrow through the shoulders, that back lat spread looks great. This side tricep also, I mean, amazing. Now look at the legs. His legs are just the freakiest legs ever. I don't know if anybody in bodybuilding today has freaky legs like this. Conditioning not great, that's why he's gonna be third spot. Also amazing, considering his conditioning. And then we're gonna... Justin Rodriguez, I think he was a little bit off with conditioning compared to Indie Pro. I think he was sharper than Indie Pro, though it was pretty close package to that one. He just doesn't have the good structure like Nick Walker to win the show, but it was kind of close. Not really that close. I think it was pretty obvious that Nick won it, but Justin did not disappoint. He brought a good level of conditioning. His back especially, I mean, it looks good. Like, it's very thick back. And here is the back lat spread. This is how you do it. I mean, he did it here properly. Then something happened at the call out and he didn't do it properly. And for that reason, he messed it up. And that's why Nick won that shot, even though he shouldn't have. But anyways, even if he did it properly, no way he could beat Nick Walker, because Nick... Oh man, Nick brought it big time. And he fixed so many poses. Back double, front double bicep actually looks much, much better. Front lat spread, so much better. So much detail, so much density, so much thickness. The polish, he was really polished. He was just good, right? Super conditioned. I mean, there is not a tiny bit of water in his glutes and hamstrings. So much muscle everywhere. Really good package. Very good package. This was the first call-out. The first time they called out these four guys. So this kind of tells you that Hassan is going to be in that top three, because... in the second callout, he was in the middle, not Dorian Haywood. So no, Dorian is not going to be third, probably. Maybe if they're not so sure and then something happened in the final, so they change their minds. But as for now, yeah, I think it's pretty... I'm 99% sure that Hassan is going to be third spot. What is wrong with Justin again? Why didn't he do the back last spread properly? I don't know. Let's not even talk about that anymore. If you guys have any interesting thoughts on this, tell me down below. Overall, I mean, a great show. I think Nick is a clear winner. Whatever you guys think, tell me down below in the comment section. Like this video if you enjoyed it. And for more New York Pro and all kinds of bodybuilding updates, subscribe to this channel, guys. Do that. Click that subscribe button. And thank you so much, guys, for watching. All the best and bye-bye.